Hi everyone, just wanted to get together and share a little bit about Manifest Automation by Xerox, or MAX, within the Advanced Automation module of FreeFlow Core. When we come into FreeFlow Core, there are a couple of different ways to submit jobs and have them processed. The first one obviously being sending through the web browser itself, so you can come here and just say submit jobs. You can drag and drop your files in and pick your workflow, and then define very specific variables about your job if need be. Another way, maybe if we're trying to communicate with an ERP system or web to print system, might be some kind of a report, right? In this case, it's going to be a CSV file. We'll just bring one of those up. You can see with this CSV file, it's going to be containing the company name, maybe an item code or a description of the actual product. It has the PDF file that FreeFlow Core is going to take in. And then it has some information about shipping as well. We can take these files and we'll copy them and we'll drop them into a hot folder. Our FreeFlow Core is going to consume those jobs. When we look at the job management status, you can see they're going to come in here and get processed. And based on that information that came in through the CSV, we can make decisions about how jobs are going to be processed. So if we look at this first one that came in, you see that there's some job information, a banner sheet really containing all the information about the job after it has printed. So we have an order number here and we have a reference code. Maybe we have an item description for a rack card. And then we have the shipping information so the folks in the back of the shop can keep everything organized. You can also add things like barcodes if we have job numbers associated with it that maybe our shipping department can scan and get some extra information. And the job is processed based on the criteria, right? So in this, we have an item description of rack card. And this rack card is being processed 4 up on a 12 by 18 sheet. If you look at the second example, we'll see now that it's a completely different order number, and the item description is actually a business card for Jen Johnson. Again, it has that shipping information on here, but as we scroll down, we'll see that it's been processed in a different way, because the business card process is going to be much different than a rack card. You can see here it's still printing on a 12 by 18 sheet, but it's set up specifically for a Duplo layout to trim these out. We look at the workflow for FreeFlow Core. What we're doing is we're routing based on the information within that CSV file. And we double click on this, we can actually see what's happening. We're actually looking at the item code and making decisions on how to do that. So we can edit these. We can see here that, you know, we're looking at a very specific variable called item code is equal to 89500. And because we know that that product code is going to be a business card or a trifold, we can process these very differently. So let's just kind of look at how those are set up. So if you go into administration and hot folders here, we'll go over to our CSV input. And we have to define a couple of different things. Number one, the hot folder location, where those files are going to be dropped into. You can create new folders here within the sandbox if you'd like, or pick an existing one. And then we pick a workflow destination. In this case, it's our CSV input. We can go over to the MAX file setup. And this is really where all that magic happens with the CSV file. We're telling FreeFlow Core what to look for and where it's located. So on these top ones here, these are pretty standard fields. And, you know, it could be a file name or folder name. You can define the quantity, paper stocks, XPIF file names. But down at the bottom, you can create custom variables. So in our example, we had column A with the order number. But column B is the line number, and we have maybe a purchase order number in here. Well, we don't have to redefine how a CSV looks. We can tell FreeFlow Core what the CSV looks like and what those variable names are called and how they work.